What's up guys, it's Ninja here, and today we're doing the Ember Army event once again. This time I changed one hero and it is Dreadrake. I changed him for Ares, and also I put Cupid here in the totem, that way gives more energy to us. The reason I changed Ares is my thinking is that the demon here is not the problem, and the heroes getting stunned is not a big problem, because however I, even if I have full garrisons, my towers are going to die anyways. So the main strategy for me here is to stay alive as long as possible, and at the meantime no other heroes should proc except mine. So that's why my Dread, my Ares and my Phantom King are going to take care of the heroes around the demon that are going to spawn while we're stacking on the demon. Unfortunately, I don't have Golem, who is going to be a better replacement for Druid, but it is how it is, we're going to try still. So back spawn. Not really something interesting. If I don't see how this works, maybe I'm going to try someone like Santa Boom or someone with a really really high DPS range damage who is going to kill a lot of heroes. I can't think of anyone except Santa. I don't know. Also, the good thing about Golem is he's going to take care like Vlad of the heroes around the demon, not only the ones who are really really far like this. So we're going to see how my Ares and my Phantom King work. Hopefully if it works like I'm thinking, nobody's going to have full energy when they come near us. So here's the demon. Let's see what goes out from this. Everyone engage the demon, and Ares and Phantom King should start proccing. Nobody is having energy except for the newly spawned waves, and we are going to kill the demon no problem. I'm not really sure if killing the demon is going to help me, if killing him faster is going to help me, but at least I have to try this one. And here, if the demon was alive, we were going to kill this Arcticus. But here my Ares procs, which is perfect, and he doesn't allow the other heroes to proc. However, we are soon going to lose that tower up there. Also, these Dreadrake procs seem to be doing really really much damage, and that's not good. Here are some revitalized heroes, and it doesn't seem really good for us. Ares has to proc a couple of times more. We saw some other procs, and I see that we are all full, or most of our health is full, and we're going to engage the demon. Somebody died, but I think he revived, unless I don't see my Ares proccing. Yeah, probably Ares died, which isn't really good. And here again stacking on the demon, and probably these Skull Knights are going to kill me. No, they're not. Somebody else died, that's my Phantom King. Not really looking good now. These Atlantic cores are going to proc, and it's going to be game over. And the Santa Boom proc 88 million. I think we're going to do better. I think we had bad luck on these procs down. Maybe I should change a little bit the base. No, just let's try. actually let's drop these bases down. And that's the only modification I'm going to do for now. If this time my Ares also dies, maybe I'll have to change something, or if he still stays alive and he doesn't work as he should, maybe then I'm going to change my strategy for the next days. The bad thing about this challenge is that you don't really get many useful rewards, it's just merits. The higher damage you get, the more merits you get, and I don't really need merits, and I don't think many people need merits right now that high level that can do so much damage. And maybe they're going to change the rewards in the future, but for now they're not really good. Here Ares procs. The bad thing is that also that the heroes every wave spawns is are 5/5 revitalized, and you either have to have really really good stun towers, or you're just going to have to reduce their energy. So let's see, we're going to engage the demon and my Thunder God procs. And here these Cupids and Santas are just going to die really fast, and the demon is going to die really fast. I don't know about the Phantom King, because he's my only scatter hero, and I don't really think, maybe it's wrong to use scatter heroes for the demon, because he's going to die faster with scatter. He's going to proc a couple of times before he dies, and that may be good for killing the other heroes, but he also reduces the energy of the other heroes on the map, not only the demon with his proc, which is really useful. But here we got a backspawn, which wasn't really nice for us, but I think we are going to stack. My Ares died, hopefully my druid heals him, and engage the demon again. Yeah, my Ares is getting healed. The demon, my Ares died. Maybe my Ares dies also because there are too many. Maybe they are flame guard heroes, or yeah, flame guard heroes mainly. Here stacking on this Skull Knight, and everybody's still alive, but these heroes are going to kill us really fast. And these are the golems, yeah, they're going to proc, and we're going to die really fast. Or we're not. That was really surprising. Also these Phantom Kings, they're really really strong, and that's why I need Golem, because he's just too powerful with the heals. Maybe my next 100 million and 4, that's not bad. Maybe my next strategy has to be getting to this demon wave 15, and then if I have the chance to stack on the demon, then I'm probably going to do better. It seems now that my Ares died too fast. Maybe I have to change that. Maybe I have to change the base or the position of Ares. I really think that Ares is going to help a lot, but if he doesn't stay alive, he's not going to help. So that was all from this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you tomorrow with another one.